Hi.
Good to see you. How are you? Good okay? You. How's your day been?
Good so far.
Good so far. Hopefully it gets better.
That's the most important thing. The rest is okay.
That is the most important thing now. This is a chance for us to have some fun. We're going to choose from 8 different fixtures where you've managed Liverpool in the Premier League. These were chosen by a fan. And I wanted to show this to you, all right, because we had this made up. Here we are, all right. Wow. So it's 8 special fixtures, but we're going to make you put them head to head in each of these, and you're gonna have to choose your favorite, and at the end of it, we'll have your Liverpool ultimate team performance, okay?
Okay.
So, I'll give this to you. This can pop right there. We've got a pen, and all you'll have to do is write the score in each of them. We'll start up here, all right? 2-1 against Aston Villa. That one's going up against 5-4 against Norwich. I wanna talk about that one specifically because 3-1 down, against Norwich. What are you saying to the players? What are you saying to the team?
This game, the 5-4, I can remember the El Malana goal, obviously, and a lot of situations I didn't like because all the goals we conceded were completely unnecessary that day, but it was early days. And the response was important. From a performance point of view, it was not such a special game. Stephen Corker we brought on in that game, that's what I remember, as a striker. So that's always a desperate action, obviously.
Centre-back or centre-forward? We'll have to wait and see where Corker's going to go.
So, yeah, spectacular, because we came back again, but performance-wise, didn't like it too much, to be honest. That's completely different with the Aston Villa game, because Aston Villa, difficult period in general, because you play a lot of football games, Champions League, all these kind of things, and then going to Villa being 1-0 down was really tough. We had in half time a bit of a discussion between players, let me say like this, they were not overly happy with each other. And then first was Sadio Cross, Robbo, second post, and next one was a corner.
Liverpool looking to claim a winner. Alexander-Arnold takes. Oh, it's gone in! Sadio Mane!
Sadio finished it off.
He did?
With his head where other people put the foot, I would say. So it was really a dangerous situation. Outstanding moment.
Okay.
So clear one.
Okay, there we go. All right, so it is the Aston Villa, the 2-1 win. Brilliant. Let's move on to the next one. Then that goes into our next round in this knockout style. Leicester 0, Liverpool 4.
Easy choice here.
Oh, really?
Easy choice.
Even over 5-1 against Arsenal. Talk to me about the Leicester one then. Why?
World Cup, we come back. We have no idea how we will respond to that. In the most busy period of English football, you go there, play 2 games, but felt really good, felt big when we won it. Coming back, nobody had an idea how we will we deal with it physically. Because time change, all these kind of things. And going there and putting this performance on the pitch was absolutely special. But this Arsenal game was a special one as well because we had, it is Bobby, when Bobby scored a hat-trick. Yeah? So, outstanding goal, by the way.
Yep.
One of the goals he scored there was, I think 2 were absolutely outstanding. One is where the whole box of, we have 5 players on their back in the box of Arsenal.
Yep.
He's just kept dancing and he's put Liverpool in front in a flash. Crazy game!
And Bobby, calm as you want. But Arsenal games in general tend to be spectacular. There's a lot of goals, these kind of things.
You described that one as wild after that game.
It was definitely wild. But we need to be wild from time to time. But the Leicester overshines, they're clear.
Right, well, let's lock that one in then. You're going for Leicester being beaten 4-0 in that one. Right, we're going to move up here. Okay. I like the reaction to this one here, okay? 2 games against a huge rival in Manchester United. In both of these games, you beat them 5-0 and then 4-0. I mean, let's go to the first one. Beating Manchester United 5-0. That's a special scoreline right there.
Played some really good stuff. After winning the ball, it's still some distance to the goal, and we had little passes. Navigator played a really good game. Top finishes. We were really all over them, and that was a really good game.
He's on an Old Trafford hat-trick here, Mo Salah. The man is extraordinary. The match is extraordinary. The scoreline is extraordinary.
This one, I would prefer probably the home game just because the atmosphere. We see the lineup or the people who will, it looks like five in the back. Oh. So when you cannot prepare for five in the back, then you play neither, especially not when you play Ralf Rangnick, and it's always a bit tricky when an opponent changed formation. But in this specific case, I really thought, I don't think he ever played five in the back in his career.
Oh, wow.
So, and if I don't play it a lot, if ever, and it's, you have to coach it, so it's different.
Yeah.
So, and I thought, okay, that could be good for us. I was not 100% sure, you never can be before the game, but it could be good for us. And then we started with the game incredibly well. We're really, again, really spot on.
Salah's on his way, and he's rolled it in for Diaz! It's taken Liverpool next to no time!
I need an answer from you then. You went for the home one. Is it, are you locking that in?
Both performances were really great, but I enjoyed the 4-0 much more.
Now, we've got to talk about the Merseyside derbies, all right. Again, we've chosen two of those. Great games, iconic wins as well. 1-0 away or 5-2 at home?
Is this 2016 Sadio Mane last minute?
Sturridge.
Oh, it's hit the post. And Mane has probably won the derby for Liverpool.
I have to take the 5-2.
Okay, talk to me about that game very quick. No. 5-2 against your local rivals. That's what you want.
Yeah, of course that's what you want. It's always, you look at the derbies, it's like a, not sure how do you say, a love-hate.
A love-hate relationship?
Yeah, it is a little bit like this. I love the derbies, but it's too big.
Fans get nervous on derby day.
Yeah, and for a long time it was too hard.
And spin in by Wijnaldum! And the Reds have ripped up derby day!
5-2?
Yeah.
Now it's going to be difficult because you've picked your initial favourites. We're going to go back to this side. The Villa game, beating them 2-1, or the Leicester game, beating them 4-0. Leicester?
Leicester.
Let's put that, we'll lock that one straight in there so we can see that. That game, I mean, you went 13 points clear in that game, in the title race as well. Did you know that this is in our hands now? We cannot slip up right here.
Good, we had a sense, but it's not that deep. We thought that that's it now. It was a top, top, top performance. And what I love most about it is just how convincing we were. And that surprised me as well a little bit. It was like, whoops, okay, that's not bad. And that gives you a good feeling for the rest of the season. But it's not necessary that it was 26th of December or whenever it was, I think it was Boxing Day, that you then know you become champion, because you don't know it definitely, but you just know, okay, the things we do work out if we are really on it.
Right, on to this side then. Another 4-0 win, this time against Manchester United, or the 5-2 against those local rivals, Everton, right there. Which one would you choose out of those two games?
The 4-0.
Oh, head-to-head of 4-0s in the final then. Yeah. I mean, it's always nice beating a rival, I guess, but is it something special? Do you know, especially when it's at home, when you're there? You've got that relationship with the Kop and the fans, haven't you?
But I'm a football fan myself, but I don't get that much out of it. Who we beat?
Okay.
That's not for me, not too important. So it's winning is winning, and good performance are good performances. But I understand, though, I know my friends all over the world, and they have all derbies everywhere and stuff like this. It's special, but the 4-0 is not special because it was against United. It was a great performance. But I understand in the supporters' mind, it's about the opponent as well, and these games matter more. And when you look back, might make it a bit sweeter, but I don't get any kind of joy out of other people's misery. So you win 4-0, and that means they have real problems. It's not that I see the bus going and think, I just don't have this sense. And like the 9-0 against Bournemouth, for example, there was nothing in where I thought, yes. It's just from a specific moment, I think, okay, now it's getting really weird.
And a hook of consolation for Scott Parker from his Liverpool counterpart.
But that's it. So, fine. Yes, it's special, but I know it's more special for the people than for me, because I just want to win.
So then we're into the final, and we're going to pick
I think
2-4-0s head-to-head right here.
It gives you already a bit of a sense. It will be, at the end, Leicester.
So in the middle, your ultimate team performance, 4-0 against Leicester. What a performance it was. What a season it was as well. And we are talking, obviously, about the teams and how special that team was. Did you know there was something special within the team, within the unit, that one season, still to this day as well, obviously?
Look, since we started pretty much getting more successful around 2018. This team was on an incredible run. Incredible run. We didn't become champions twice with 1 point against the best team in the world. So that shows you how consistent we were. Yes, we knew we have something special here, but in the Premier League that doesn't mean anything. You become second, but winning the decisive games in the end makes obviously a big difference. And that's why we were already, after winning the Champions League the year before, or in that year, and then just keep going. We just kept going, and that was really cool. We enjoyed that time a lot, but it's not that you can really enjoy it in the sense of laying back. It's super intense.
Oh, I can imagine.
Wow, it's
super
intense.
I can imagine.
I gotta start sweating now when I just think about it. But it's, no, good.
Right, well, you've gone through all of them. We started with eight, we've whittled it all the way down, and we have this final one. All we need you to do now is to sign it and confirm that this is your choice. Right here by Jürgen Klopp. Perfect, there we go.
I signed with Klopp.
I like that. And then let's show it to the camera as well. Right here. I mean, the camera's there, the stage is yours.
Oh, Liverpool's ultimate team performance by Jürgen Klopp. That's obviously me. And it is Leicester. 26th of December, I'm pretty sure, Boxing Day 2019. I'm actually a bit disappointed. There must have been more great games.
Oh, so many great games.
Yeah, okay.
Well, these are some of the fan favourites that we spoke to. I made sure I got some of the iconic ones. But Jürgen, honestly, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure to go through some of these and relive some of the highlights. But you are right. There's plenty that have been in the past, and there's plenty more to come.
Best,
and I'm looking forward to seeing it.
The best are still to come. That's actually the message of the day. That's
definitely
what would be my favourite.
Brilliant. Thank you.
Thank you.